subscribe to our channel now and press the bell icon to never miss an update from KIMS Global.
Hi, I'm Dr. Vidyalekshmi. I work as a senior consultant in the Department of High-Risk Pregnancy and Fetal Medicine at KIMS Hospital, Trivandrum. I'll take this as two sessions. One is the test. The routine tests which we use for a low-risk pregnancy are applicable to high-risk women also. There's a first trimester nuchal scan plus the combined double marker screening test between 12 and 13 weeks. And if she is found high-risk, these women are offered two diagnostic tests and they are called chorionic sampling, which can be done between about 11 weeks to 13, 14 weeks, where we take the sample of the placenta by a needle. And the second test is at 16 weeks of pregnancy, which is called amniocentesis, which also involves a needle which goes in and takes some fluid from around the baby. And these are the two tests which we routinely use for diagnosis of high-risk pregnancy, for depending upon what she wants. Like for example, if she has found high-risk for Down syndrome, this is used to check for the karyotype or the chromosomes. Or if she has a previous baby with a problem like a genetic disease, the DNA from the chorionic sampling or from the amniotic fluid is used to find out whether this baby carries or is a carrier or is a affected baby for that particular disease. Unless we have the patient screened or the previous baby screened or know what we are looking for, we can't do these tests just because she is pregnant and has a baby who is affected in the past. So this is the work which should be done before she even plans pregnant or if she is in the early pregnancy itself. The next test which is offered is the 18 week scan, which is called the targeted anomaly scan or TIFA. Here what is happening is the baby is looked at from the head to foot, look for all the structures, look for the growth of the baby, look for the placenta, look for additional things, look for markers for genetic disorders, and it's a detailed evaluation. And then comes a fetal echo, which happens around 20 to 22 to 23 weeks of pregnancy, where the baby's heart is evaluated in detail. For those sort of women who had a baby with a heart disease in the past, or who is diabetic before she is pregnant, or she is on some medications which are a higher risk for heart disease in the newborn or the fetus. And the growth scans are very important, especially in those women who had a baby who was small in the last pregnancy, who had a stillbirth, who had an intrauterine death in the past pregnancy, and so on and so forth. And there are some other diagnostic tests and therapeutic modalities in the fetal medicine, which is looking for the baby's anemia, whether the baby is anemic or not. As when she is negative blood group, the husband is positive and the baby is getting affected by the antibodies which is coming from the father's blood group. So these are the situations when we look whether the baby is becoming anemic or not. We have modalities, we can do transfusions, that is called intrauterine transfusion. So the baby is given blood inside the uterus so that the baby can be saved. The main therapy which is grown enormously in the West and in our country too is using the laser and other modalities to treat pregnancies called especially twins, which are monochorionic, that is when they share the common placenta. So those parents who have babies with monochorionic twins, they are the only one who has to address this problem, where the babies can have problems like a twin transfusion syndrome, a twin reverse arterial perfusion, a twin anemia polycythemia sequence. And these are the babies where we go inside the womb and treat the babies by doing a procedure called laser photocoagulation, which is a very high-end procedure in the fetus. And the other small things which are done is to give transfusion, as I already mentioned, to do the amniocentesis, the chorionic sampling, to do a blood wrap analysis from the fetus, that is called fetal blood sampling, and so on and so forth. And we do fetal therapies, we give medications to the mother to save the fetus, and we can even give the medicines to the amniotic cavity to help the baby in certain situations.